Hey, it's another episode of Spontaneous Chuck. And, buddy, today we're talking nothing but Mountaineer sports. You know what? How about that basketball team? Man, I tell you what, off to the Final Four, first time since 1959, and when the logo took them there. That is fantastic. I'll tell you what, I'm not normally a big normally I'm not a big sports guy, to be honest with you. I am, but just more oddball sports. I mean, I watch it, but I'm not crazy. Some people are just nut jobs about it, and I'm not a nut job about it. But, man, I tell you what, these ball games, they have been giving me, acid reflux. I've been nervous, you know, it's great entertainment. And those guys are just fantastic. Hats off to them. And that's why I'm wearing my West Virginia gear, even though I don't have my sweatshirt on. But I do have my hat on. I tell you what, man, them Mountaineers, man, they are back. They're bad. Told you I had my hat on. I just playing. Hey, but anyway, when I think of Mountaineer football, you know, growing up in the area of Morgantown, per se, we used to go to Mountaineer Field all the time. I can remember, because my grandparents lived in Morgantown, the cool thing about it is when the stadium was over on Sunnyside, and we would come down and where the old stadium was, right? And it used to be a bridge that goes across there now, or whatever the economics building is. And they would. One thing that I can remember plain as day is the drunk bus, and I loved that thing. It was like a school bus. They had chicken wire or some kind of steel, and they just get everybody. And man, they just throw you right in the damn bus and take you to jail. It was fantastic. Just good times there. But to be quite honest with you, like I said, one of the big things, and probably if you're a Mountaineer fan, I mean, if you grow up with them. One of the great things about, because, you know, let's be honest with you, Mountaineer football and basketball, it wasn't what it is today. I mean, if you know, it had its years, but it wasn't nearly as consistent, and it wasn't nearly, I mean, we were lucky to beat Pitt. We never did beat Penn State. So, you know, now it's a completely different story. At least we have a chance for it. But what made it so cool growing up and being fortunate enough to be around here is hearing Jack Fleming and Woody call the game. Man, I tell you what, I can just remember being at the field when they had the loudspeakers after the games, and hearing those two, just Jack Fleming in particular, old school, just, you know what, just fantastic. And anytime I think of it, honest to goodness, I just always go back to that, just because I grew up with it, that's all. And it's just to hear his voice, honest to goodness, is just the best. For me, personally, the best. I mean, he called Steeler games, the Immaculate Reception. You know what? But Mountaineer football games, buddy, when you could hear those two on the radio, it was just fantastic. Now, some people, you know, don't even know who Jack Fleming is, which is why Spontaneous Chuck is on the air today. Because, like I said, this has really nothing to do with basketball or football in general. But most of, Jack's greatest hits, per se, came definitely when they were playing on the gridiron, which we're going to do a little tribute here, tribute video that I found to play for Jack. If you don't know who Jack is, check this out. It brings a tear to my eye because the guy was fantastic. But anyway, until next time, let's go Mountaineers, baby. Spontaneous Chuck, peace out, baby. I love y'all.
Virginia resound with the sounds of Mountaineers in combat, and the West Virginia University Mountaineers are on the air.
Yeah. 30, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, West Virginia.
Here's a fake. Hostetler keeps the ball, rolls around the right side into the end zone to score. Hostetler with a great fake. He tears it around the right side. He takes it in.
Willie D behind the 30, comes over the 30, over the 35, the 40, over the 45, the 50, down to the 10, 45, swings to the right, over the 40, the 35, the 30, the 25, the 20. He's off and running the 10, the 5. Touchdown, West Virginia.
Here's Flutie being chased thereafter. Did they get him? They got him! They got him back at the 27-yard line! They got him! That was Matt Smith, the linebacker. They got Flutie. They got him that time. All afternoon they've been chasing him. All afternoon they've pursued him. And they got him.
Blanker out wide, and the handoff given to Randall, with blocker, swings out to the right, cuts down to the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5, touchdown with Virginia! Goal, Pat Scott Barrows with a block for the Mountaineers. Barrows pulling and leading the blocking, and Pat Randolph racing into the end zone, and West Virginia scores from 22 yards. Harrison trouble, stiff arms, a would-be Packer comes out over the 25 to 20. Goes around about at the 15, at the end of 5. A touchdown with Virginia. He did it. What a move he made on the first tackler. What a move he made on the second, on the third. And he gallops in for the touchdown. Takes it all
the way. Hands it off to Walker. Walker through the left side. Walker's going for a touchdown. He came over the left side. Cut to the outside. Outran everybody. 19-yard run. Robert Walker for the TD.
Studstill firing for the end zone.
And a catch to the end zone. Touchdown, West Virginia, as the ball is pulled in by Ed Hill. Tightly covered. Hill gave the defensive guy a little push. He pulls it in, and the Mountaineers take a 15-14 lead. Holy smokes.